Welcome friends, my name is Sagar Deshmukh. In the previous video, we have discussed the definition of surveying, objectives of surveying, importance of surveying, principles of surveying, and classification of survey. After that, we also discussed the kinds of error. Today, I will revise this part quickly and then we'll move towards the next part of surveying. So, definition of surveying is the branch of civil engineering in which the relative positions of points on earth is determined with respect to linear and angular measurement, or by with the help of linear and angular measurement. So this is the definition of surveying. In short, in the surveying we are locating the ground data with respect to some fixed point. So this is the concept of surveying. We have also discussed the objectives of surveying. The objectives of surveying are to take the measure the distance between two points, to prepare the map, to prepare the plan, to measure the area, to locate new point. So these are the objectives of surveying. You can add objectives according to your study also. Importance of surveying is already discussed by us. Principles of surveying. There are two principles of surveying. First one is to work from whole to part, and the second principle of surveying is to locate new station with at least two measurement from fixed and permanent points, relatively fixed and permanent points. So these are the principles of surveying. First was to locate to work from whole to part, and second one is to locate a new station with at least two measurement from relatively fixed and permanent point. We have also discussed the explanation of principles of surveying. After that, we have discussed the units in the measurement of survey. As we are measuring length and angular distance, so we should know the measurement of length. Unit of length, angular measurements, and area. So these are the units which mostly required in the surveying. But as today we are having the smartphones with us, so we can convert this measurement easily. But you should know the standard convergence in order to get quick understanding of the survey field. After that, we have discussed classification of survey. The classification of primary classification of survey is based on the curvature effect of earth, or the area of extent of surveying. So there are two primary types of surveying. First one is plane surveying, second one is geodetic surveying. Plane surveying is the branch of surveying in which the curvature of earth is not considered. It means earth is considered as plane surface. So that type of surveying is called as plane surveying. When the curvature of earth is taken into consideration for survey, then it is called as geodetic surveying. Plane surveying is done for the area lesser than 250 km², whereas geodetic survey is performed where the area is greater than 250 km². Means we can readily understand that geodetic surveying is carried out for the larger project, like to locate the map of particular state or country, or to prepare the map of earth. This type of geodetic survey are used, whereas plane surveying is used for small engineering projects, all the building projects and the construction small construction projects are performed with plane survey, because the error due to curvature is very negligible. After that, we have discussed kinds of error. We know that if we are taking measurements in surveying, there must be some error due to some adversities or due to the defects of instruments or some unknown problem, because of some unknown problem. So we should know what type of error may come in the measurement observing. So there are three types of error: mistake, systematic error, accidental error. I had already told you that systematic error is also called as cumulative error, whereas accidental error is also called as compensating error. Mistake, this type of error can be happen due to the carelessness, inexperience of observer, or confusion in mind of observer or the person who is making the entry, or if the person who is making the entry overlooks some digits, then the mistake may happen. In order to avoid this error due to mistake, we should take independent check on every edge measurement. In that case, we can completely exclude or eliminate this error. If one observation is done by two different observers independently, then the error due to mistake can be eliminated. Now we'll move towards the systematic error. Systematic error, as its name denotes, these are systematic in manner. Means such type of errors are constant in value or magnitude and sign for particular measurement. Means suppose if you are taking particular measurement, in that measurement if systematic error arised, then the value of systematic error for that particular measurement will be same during the project, and its sign also will remain same. So such type of error are called as systematic error. The third type of error is accidental error. Accidental errors are the errors which left after mistake and systematic error are eliminated from the measurement. This type of error cannot be determined 100%, because of which we use laws of probability for the determination of accidental errors. So this is about the kinds of error. Today we'll discuss regarding the precision and accuracy. This precision and accuracy many times used for the same meaning in general language, but in surveying these two words have different meaning, precision and accuracy. So I will define the word precision and accuracy first, words precision and accuracy first, and then we'll take one example to understand this concept of precision and accuracy. First of all, we'll see definition of precision. In a set of measurement, the nearness of one measurement with other measurement, that is called as precision. Whereas accuracy in a set of measurement is nearness of average value of set to the true value is so this is accuracy. Now I will explain this precision and accuracy with the popular example of dart hitting game. In this game, the player needs to hit the target at center with dart. So I have taken two cases. In this two rounds, five opponent had made the given target. In the first case, in the first round, the opponent of team had made this target 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This three targets had been made by the players in the first round. Whereas in the second round, the participant had made the target at this point 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now if we calculate the average of this result, you can see that there are some targets which are very nearer to the true value. So if you take average of this, it will be nearest to the true value. So such type of hitting will be called as accurate hitting. But in this case, you can see that there is no target reaching towards the center, but all the targets are near to each other. So this case of target hitting is called as precise hitting, and this is called as accurate hitting. So when in the third case, suppose these targets are like this, then this target will be called as a precise and accurate. Okay, because they are nearer to the true value as well as they are nearer from each other. So this set of target will be called as accurate and precise hitting. So this is how the concept of precision and accuracy is there. In order to increase the accuracy in measurement, we have to take number of measurements. Means as the number of measurements of same field increases, the accuracy increases. Now we'll see how to measure the length with respect with tapes. What are the types of tapes? Which tape is better for measurement? So we'll see this now in the next part. In surveying, five types of tapes are generally used for the linear measurement. Namely, they are first linen tape. We also call this as a cloth tape. Second, oven metallic tape or simply metallic tape. Third, steel tape. Steel tape. Fourth one is synthetic tape. And the last one is Invar tape. We'll take the introduction of every tape one by one. Linen tape, also known as cloth tape, is a varnished strip made of closely woven linen. The width of strip is from 12 to 16 mm. It is available in different lengths of 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, 50 meter. Both ends of linen tape are provided with metallic handles. Whole tape is wounded in leather or metal case. Linen tapes are light in weight and easy to handle. These tapes may shrink when exposed to the water and also elongates when pulled. Hence, these tapes are not suitable for accurate surveying measurement. These are generally used for measuring offset and for ordinary works. So this is about the metallic tape. Now we'll see, this is about linen tape. Now we'll see metallic tape. The metallic woven tape is an improved version of linen tape. The brass or copper copper made wires are used as a reinforcement for linen material. Hence, it is more durable than normal linen tape. A brass ring is provided at the end of tape, which is included in the length of tape. These tapes are available in the length of 2 meter, 10 meter, 15 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter and 50 meter. These are used for survey works such as topographical survey. Topographical survey. these are used for topographical surveys, survey works where minor error are not taken into consideration. So minor error are arised in this tape. Third is steel tape. A steel tape is made of steel or stainless steel. It consists of strip of 6 mm to 16 mm wide. Its width is ranging between 6 mm to 16 mm. It is also available in the length of 5 meter, 8 meter, 10 meter, 20 meter, 50 meter. In this tape, meter, decimeter, centimeter are graduated. Steel tapes are generally came up with the metal case with automatic winding device. The tape is withdrawn from the case by using hand during the measurement, and it is rewounded into the case by just pressing the button provided on the case. Steel tapes are not flexible, are suitable for measuring level surface only. They may corrode easily when exposed to the moisture, and to prevent this, tape should be cleaned and oiled after use. These tapes are generally used for standardizing chains, measurement of construction works, etc. Now we'll move towards the synthetic tape. Synthetic tapes are made of glass fiber coated with PVC. These tapes are light in weight and flexible. They are also available in the length of 5 meter, 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter and 50 meter. Synthetic tapes may stretch when subjected to tension, hence these are not suitable for accurate surveying work. However, synthetic tapes are recommended in the place of steel tapes where it is essential to take the measurement in the vicinity of electric fences and railway lines. Now we'll move towards the last and most important tape, that is Invar tape. Invar tapes are made up of alloy which consists of 36% of nickel and 64% of steel. Invar tape contains 6 mm wide strip. So width of this strips are 6 mm. The coefficient of thermal expansion of Invar alloy is very low. It is not affected by changes in temperature. Hence, these tapes are used as used in high precision works in surveying such as baseline measurement, triangulation survey, etc. Invar tapes are expensive than all other types of tapes. These tapes should be handled with care, otherwise bends or the kinks may form. So if we summarize these tapes, we can see that this Invar tape is the most accurate type of tape which can be used for the measurement because of its accuracy. Its cost is also high. The metallic tape, question on metallic tape is many time asked in the competitive examination, like which type of tape is made up of with cloth and the metal wires. So the answer is metallic tape. Metallic tapes are made up of the metal wire and cloth, linen. So we should remember these two tapes. So this is about the classification of tapes. In the next lecture, we'll see the next part of surveying. So for this video, thank you.